agency that investigates murders is again in the hot seat, and the focus is the former chief investigator at the medical examiner's office. There are claims of sex crimes and mishandled evidence. And Eyewitness News Size Linda Mattis is live with that investigation. Linda?
Paul, Kevin Rowland testified in front of a grand jury today, and his attorney says they've read through the documents, but what they want to know is what happens next.
He spent 20 years at the medical examiner's office. Now Kevin Rowland and the medical examiner's office are both under the microscope.
Now he's sitting on pins and needles at home wondering what's going on.
A multi-county grand jury says some of the ME's employees were victimized psychologically, emotionally, and sexually. And those in charge turned a blind eye to the chief investigator's behavior. The grand jury says Kevin Rowland's behavior was abrasive, sexually harassing, and sometimes violated criminal law.
I don't know whether he did or not, but even if he did, so what? Grow up, quit being a crybaby.
Grand jury witnesses testified they filed grievances, but their paperwork was either lost or stolen along the way. The grand jury also criticized the way potential evidence was handled, saying blood-stained clothing was hung where it could be cross-contaminated and open boxes of evidence were stored next to trash bins.
We have changed the way we collect the evidence when it comes in.
Spokesperson Cherokee Ballard says the ME's office is taking action, but she says it needs help.
We need more funding for more people, more space, and more equipment.
An indictment was issued today, but it was sealed. So Rowland's attorney says he doesn't know if his client will be charged, but he says if that happens, he won't be surprised. Reporting live, I'm Linda Mattis, Eyewitness News 5.
And it was just earlier this month, the ME's office lost its national accreditation. An inspector said equipment was out of date and more workers were needed. The new chief says he is working on all of it.